What you managed to do was to take this character that, you know, the perception of her was rather negative, and turn it into a very interesting and vulnerable story. You read the script, and what was your immediate response to it?
When I read the script, I didn't know it was a true story. I thought it was a very bizarre and specific script. I thought, wow, this writer's out of his mind, but I love it, and it works. And then I found out it was true, and then I was even more taken with it, and in fact, understood what restraint and sophistication he took to kind of weave in the intricate details, but also all the opposing narratives and everything that went along. But the script in general just felt very original. It felt very rebellious. It felt like it was breaking every rule that a script normally follows. And, you know, I guess we all read so many scripts. I feel like sometimes I know, okay, now coming up to the inciting incident and the second point, the turning point, and act three, you know, like you kind of know what's coming. And with this script, I did not know what was going to happen on every mm-hmm. single page. And, mm-hmm. and the mixture of tones, the fact that I was laughing out loud reading something and then a second later feeling really weird that I had laughed about it and start thinking, God, am I a bad person that I found that funny? And it challenged me as a reader, and therefore I found it extremely
engaging. And you knew how to ice skate already, so you had, at least you weren't, because I read that you had ice skated.
I grew up in Australia on the Gold Coast, so there wasn't any ice, and I didn't grow up ice skating, which would have been really
helpful. You played hockey or something though, right?
But when I moved to America, because I was obsessed with the Mighty Ducks when I was little, when I moved to America, I was like, well, I'm in America now, I can pretty much live out my Mighty Ducks fantasy and join an ice hockey team, and I did, and I was 20, and I had so much padding on, it really didn't matter that I didn't know how to ice skate, because I'd just bash right. into things, and in hindsight I was really just sprinting on the ice. But once I put on figure skating skates to train for this film, I realized what an art form, an incredibly difficult sport it is.
And did you meet Tonya Harding before you decided to produce and star in the movie?
No. Okay. I wanted to produce and star in it the second I read this script, and that's before I even knew Tonya Harding was a person. But to be honest, it was the best way to approach this material, because I didn't have any preconceived notions. I didn't have any judgment about these people or the situation or what I thought had happened. And honestly, from the acting point of view, that was definitely the best way to approach the character. But from the producing point of view, it was also a brilliant approach, because we did want to explore the greater themes as opposed to the specific details.
Correct.
It wasn't about finger pointing who did what. It was really about, okay, why do people remember the same thing differently? Why do people tell themselves something in order to justify their actions at the time? Why does the media portray women in a certain way, and why do we consume that media in a certain way, and what are the effects that we're having on society because of all that? There were so many bigger themes. There was also a lot of characters who felt very disenfranchised, and that also felt extremely relevant. There were so many bigger questions and so many questions posed in the script that made it feel important. I mean, every time we look at a script, it's not can we make this, it's should we make this?
Right.
And there's a lot of scripts you read where you're like, well, I can see that this, we could actually get this going pretty quickly, and that's obviously attractive because we need to pay, you know, the bills at the office. But it's also, if we can't really come up with a good answer to why we should make this film, then we don't go after it.
Well, what you've shown though too is it, you what your experience suggests is it adheres to a line that I wrote, a line that I read that was very important to me, where I read this line that said that the pessimism of an old person is not truer than the optimism of a young person. And actually, you reading this and not knowing the backstory and everything made you optimistic about the character and what the character could accomplish. I think that should be something that all of us should try to remember, especially as those of us that are getting older. We have to remember what our young optimistic selves were like.